Well, my name is Liz Kaprielien, and I'm from the Framingham Club. And I've only a Rotarian for about 3 years. And when I joined my club, I asked them the question, what would you like help with? And a little bit to my dismay, they said, our Facebook page. And at that time, I didn't even have a personal Facebook page, and I didn't know anything about Facebook. And so I said, gee, I don't know. But social media night came along. And so I went to social media night, and I went to their Facebook 101 at that time, and I said, okay, you know, I felt confident enough from that I could go home and give it a shot. And that's what I hope to give you as well, is at least the confidence to feel like maybe you could do it, or maybe you could get some other club members to help you with it. So that to give you some sort of stage. And then 2 years from now, you're expected to come back here and give Facebook 101. So let's just talk a little bit about our agenda here. So I have about 20 minutes to talk to you. We're starting a little bit early, so that's nice to have a little bit of extra time. How many people here actually have a personal Facebook page? Okay, and how many people have, their club has a Facebook page? So our club had a Facebook page as well, but it had been pretty much, I guess you would call it abandoned for a while. The person who had been doing it had somewhat been pressured to try and help out, wasn't really a big fan, didn't really want to spend the time on that, and kind of wanted to help the club in other ways. So they were really looking for someone to, you know, please take this on. They knew social media was going to be something that the club really wanted to get involved in, but they hadn't had a volunteer come forward yet. So the social media night really was exciting for me, and to be able to go to the different tracks and to hear the different, you know, clubs, what they were all doing. So tonight what we're going to do is we're going to look a little bit at the mechanics. I think for me that was a little scary. It's like, I don't understand this light. I don't understand, like, how it works. I don't understand how to set it up. Oh my God, can I do this? You know, I thought it was going to be really complicated, very scary. The only good thing was that the club already had its own Facebook page up. But having never done my own Facebook page, I really felt like kind of at a loss. So we'll go through those pretty quickly because some people actually have done that part. We'll talk a little bit about the setting up of a page for yourself and a club. Events, which are a sort of like a little side thing on Facebook. A lot of people set up their Facebook, but they don't necessarily, as a club, go for the events part of it, which I learned very quickly was quite powerful and something that you really want to try and take advantage of. And then the cover page, okay? The cover page for Facebook, the image that you see when you land on a Facebook page, it's horizontal, and that actually poses a few technical challenges. Talk about that. And then, of course, then you get into the administration. Well, who's running this thing anyway? You know, like, how are we going to keep this up? What should you think about as a club? How can you break it down? And then content. You know, what are you posting? You know, when should you post? What do you want to post? And your keynote speaker spoke about that, but I think you can get down to some practicalities. After 2 years of chipping away at it, we kind of came up with a system that, you know, we'll talk about here today that might be useful for your club. Okay, and this is sort of a recap. You saw what she was blowing by there with the, you know, why is social media so important? This was actually from a presentation in my company about 2 years ago, which was kind of interesting, you know, how much is going on. I'm also a Salesforce administrator, and Salesforce is one of the cloud-based companies. They're one of the first companies to kind of allow you to do your business in the cloud. And they have a 1 minute, like, from, you know, Stone Age to now, which is very similar to what you saw tonight, that the speed at which things are changing and information is going around now much more electronically is pretty amazing. And it also was very exciting. They always start off Salesforce conferences now by showing you the latest version of that video where the numbers are just exponentially, you know, huger every second, which it can sound a little intimidating. I will tell you right now that our club is doing Facebook. However, we have made a conscious choice to skip Twitter for the moment. So that's like another channel that we feel we don't have enough time or bandwidth to address. And we don't want to step into it weekly. We want to do it strongly if we do it. And so we're still mastering our Facebook, and we're like, you know, one thing at a time, let's do it well. And Yelp is just on there because it's another whole animal that, you know, that's going on. People hear about Yelp all the time for rating things. It's very busy. So the mechanics, setting up your own Facebook page, your personal page, right? A lot of people are very fearful of setting up a Facebook page. You know, I don't want people seeing information. My brother has a Facebook page that has absolutely nothing, no picture, no birth date, new information. I mean, it's kind of creepy looking. It's so grayed out. But he wanted to be on Facebook so he could follow things, but he doesn't want to talk to anybody. He doesn't want anybody finding him. So he wants to kind of be stealth under the radar, but get the advantage of following. And I think you notice in the keynote speaker's comments, there's a lot of people following, right? A lot of people are just sort of turning on the TV kind of concept. I'll watch, I don't need to get involved, but I want to know. So that's something to kind of think about. You can set up your personal Facebook page very thin, right? But to have a club page, you can't set up a club page unless it's tied to a human being, a personal Facebook page. And that was a surprise to me when I came to one-on-one. So our club had a Facebook page, but if we had not and we wanted to start one, someone would have had to have a personal page first and then go on and say, I wish to have a club page and it is tied to you behind the scenes. Now, there's nothing for you as a consumer of a club page to know that that is tied to one human being on the planet, but it is somewhere in the background. And that person's probably your administrator, and you can have multiple people administrating. Your club's Facebook page will have more information that's about your club and administering on that. So we're going to go through these. So when you actually go into Facebook, they have a very nice little walkthrough, how to create one. And which, by the way, a lot of these mechanics and stuff, it can look a little busy here. This whole deck is up on the district site. So, you know, don't feel you have to write all this down. Just remember you can go up and get it there and you can kind of dig into it. You know, they're going to walk you through this. And, you know, you have to kind of think about your name now, what you want to call it. You know, sort of think ahead. And what I would recommend is if you're thinking about it or if you want to do kind of a revamp of what you already have, that maybe you have a page for your club and it's kind of, you know, it's been hanging around for a while and you're sort of like, well, maybe we need to rethink it. I would recommend that you take a look at the Facebook pages for the clubs that are physically around you because they're communicating to the community of users that are around you. So I went off to look at, you know, I'm in Framingham. I went off to see what the Natick Club was doing for their page, which is actually quite a busy page. Went to take out, you know, what's Westboro doing, Southboro. The presenter was from Brookline and they do this fabulous extravaganza on chocolate. And they had a very interesting Facebook story. And so theirs was a very busy site. I went to see what that was like. Went and checked out the district site. And for a while, we actually tracked how many people were following those sites to see where did we stack up. And it was way low. and we discovered that, in fact, the Brookline Club had lost control of and access to their club website. There had been some sort of complication. And so they were left with no website. And so they basically fired up their Facebook page to do it all. And so they were really using that hard. We've never used our Facebook that hard, but you know they learned a ton real fast because that was it. It was that or nothing until they could sort out their whole website. I happen to know of two groups. One's a dance group, another is another business. They aren't doing a website. They're only doing Facebook. Their entire business, everything through Facebook. So there are people that go that path. I think that you kind of need both when you're in Rotary and you're doing the club thing. So it walks you through this pretty carefully. You're going to be asked to select a category, right? And there's a category right there for community service, that kind of thing. That's the yellow one I've highlighted. And you know, then it asks you what do you want to call it, right? See, nonprofit. And you can see I've scattered tips throughout here. These tips are also excerpted and they're on a separate sheet. So afterwards you can kind of take a look at them. You know, you want to follow the Rotary branding here. Okay, so we had an old Facebook page and it was called Framingham Rotary. Well, things are turning around, right? It's really not about Framingham, it's about Rotary. That's the brand. In fact, it's Framingham is important to us, but Rotary, Rotary, Rotary. So we actually had one chance where Facebook allows you to rename it, and we took that chance and changed it over to Rotary Club of Framingham. So even though it was existing, we were able to present now Rotary Club of Framingham. So you kind of get one shot to do that. So it's like you need to, having looked at other club stuff, you can kind of get a sense for yourself, make notes, like, so when you go ahead to set it up, you want to kind of maybe think of these things. And this is where you're going to sort of put this key information. Now, I highlighted this because the bottom section in very tiny type, that's where we had that chance to make the change. And what was interesting about this, I'm going through their little getting started here, and I went and took this. As you'll notice, it actually, I think, says something like Rotary Club of XXX, right? Because I wanted to get these screenshots, right? Because our club's page is already set up, but I wanted to capture that walkthrough. So I put that in there, and this looks pretty safe, and it just says, you know, getting started and next. And actually, as soon as I hit the next, it wasn't just getting started. It really went out there, and it created a Facebook page called Rotary Club of XXX, which is now tied to me because I went to set it up, right? Which was this, so I was like, you know, that's the kind of stuff that drives people nuts about Facebook. Now, as a business person, you look at that, getting started and going forward does not mean that just got built. You know, saying I'm going to bake it does not mean it got in the oven. But so Facebook has a few things that we have to always remember in its DNA. You know, it, a couple of guys getting together, or actually one guy really getting, you know, deciding, we kind of want students talk to each other and rate girls, you know? I mean, that's its borderline baseline DNA. It was never Microsoft building something for business. And so sometimes it can feel like, I can't believe I can't do X, Y, or Z on it if you have a business background. Like, this is one of those. And I'll have to find out from Facebook, can I ever kill that thing? You know, they're not big about getting rid of stuff. Here we go. So let's talk about navigation. So I've actually got here is my page. Right, it's my personal page, right? And there's actually, no, I can't even see this. So I have to put my glasses on. Excuse me for a minute. All right, so at the top, there's my name. And next to that is home, and there's a little number by it. And this is kind of like its main navigation approach in Facebook, which took me a little while to figure out. There's not a lot of like how-to. They just figure you're going to wander around and click stuff, and maybe your friend will show you. But that home is what's going to lead you to what looks like a very busy, action-packed place. And that's where everything that you're following, and all the news that you decided to get, and everybody that you like, that's all going to be on the next page. But your main page here, where you land, that's kind of what you said. So there's my little cover page, there's a little quilt, and you notice my picture is there, that little square. Yeah, I can't control that. I can put my picture there, but that block is in the way. Okay, I can't get rid of it. I also can't get rid of my name in white, and I can't get rid of those two white buttons. So Facebook is dictating that look and feel. And tomorrow, they may change that, and you'll have no control over that, right? So there's some real estate here that you can't really manage, right? It's just the way it comes. Your name always will lead to this kind of page. The page is split into kind of two columns. The right column is where you get to post out to people saying, you know, hey, this is what I just did. This is what I just saw. This is what I just, you know, found. Here's my picture. Here's the video. So that's where you're talking. And you can see sort of grayed out down below is a picture of a quilt block I just sent out to my friends. The left-hand column is, that's the information you chose when you set up your Facebook and your preferences. You said, sure, I'll tell you where I live and what my birth date is and you know, what I like and what movies I'm following and what books I like and, oh, yeah, what universities I went to. And this is what my brother filled out, nothing. And I know several ladies who put in a false birth date because they just don't like this whole thing. Right, so I mean, they're like years younger, and you know, not because it's like no, they're like 20 years younger. They just don't like that at all. They don't like that anybody's tracking their birth date, and I know there's a lot of people don't like that. But I think that might be one of the required ones, so they just jack it.
You don't have to specify the year.
Oh well, so that's an improvement, I think, over what it used to be. So that's kind of the basics of where you end on that. So here's that home, right? So you click the home, and there's a lot of action going on. And I remember being really confused by this the first time I came. So now you can see I got a little arrow there. This is pages. There's a little section over there, pages. So you see there's the Rotary Club of Framingham, because I'm connected to that. And under it is the crappy Rotary Club of XXX, because I'm connected to that now. Yes, yeah, great one, right? So the pages that you have been given administrator rights to will show there. Right, that's where it'll be. When somebody, so if you have a club page and somebody says, well, we're going to let you post to it now, you're going to be an administrator. When you come to your Facebook page and you go to your home, there it will be. Suddenly a link to get to it will be right there. And then in the middle column is kind of all this information seems to be flowing at you. And some of you say to yourself, I don't remember saying I ever cared about any of this, but it'll be there. So we're going to continue on. So when you click that and you went to your club, this is what our club's Facebook page happens to look like right now. Right, so it's kind of similar, but it's a little bit different. Right, so the about section now is not about me. It's what you chose to say about your club. And a lot of people like to click, when they go to your club's page, they'll click about, because that's where you said stuff like, we meet at Ken's, we're looking for new members, we're located at X. There's quite a bit you can kind of put there. And you can change that all the time. But usually you kind of got your basics there, and you want to make sure that that's not empty. Right? That's kind of like the equivalent of saying your physical location where you're at. So that's the key information you want to get there. Likes, what the heck is a like? So somebody came to your Facebook page and said, hey, this is pretty cool. I want to keep track of what they're doing. Right? So they were in Facebook on their own page. They went out and they said, oh, Rotary. And they, oh, look, there's a Rotary Club in my town. Landed on your page, and there's a button there that says like. And they click that. And then it changes to the word liked, as in, yeah, you already said you liked it. And over on their homepage, every time you post something, it goes, yo, that page you liked, they just had something to say. So that's how that flow, everybody liking stuff that you hear about all the time, is people clicking that, and suddenly it's flowing. Yeah? Yes, as an administrator, you get to see that kind of thing. You get to see, you know, this person just liked your page.
Okay, so it goes back.
It goes back. So an administrator sees that. Your club members who are just generally coming here, they might not see that. Right? And on your club page, it'll keep track and show you 200 likes, which, by the way, thank you very much. Our club just hit the mythical 200 likes mark, which doesn't sound like much, but we were at like 40 people had clicked like. Pretty distressing. Yes, but I wouldn't. Yes, you can see everybody who's been liking you, but it's not what I would call business friendly. So it's not a nice little export button.
You can't get a like a list.
Okay. No, they're not thinking that. They think it's all in the moment. Fred just liked you. Wow. Maybe you click and say, thanks, Fred, and that's it. Like, they're not thinking, I'd like to know all the 100 people that like me this year. Like, I have to kind of fish that out. Now, maybe there is a way. This is Facebook 101, and we're still learning, right? But good question. Yeah, we do pay attention to who liked us and who also shared our content. All right, so let's say we post something really cool. There's a little link below what you post that says share. So you come over to another club's page and you see this great event, and you can share it to yourself, to your own Facebook page, or to your club's page. All right, so there's an option to do that. Let's see. So you and administrators of your page can post a comment, a photo, a video right into this. And that's what that little empty block is right below my pretty graphic. And you can change this graphic, this cover graphic, but we'll talk about that. So the question becomes, how comfortable are you posting as you? Because you're on this page and you can say, I'm Liz and I'm making this comment, or there's a nicer way, I think. As an administrator, you have the rights to go up to this little pull down and say, you're going to post as the club. So I know some people don't like to volunteer for Facebook work because they don't want their name associated with all this posting. They don't want that. Well, this is how you can become an administrator for your club, and you can post as the club. And so it just says Rotary Club of whatever posted this comment. So that's one hurdle to kind of get past some folks who might be like, yeah, no, wait a minute. I don't want anybody thinking I'm out there posting this stuff, right? So that's one way we immediately kind of adopted that. So you switch. You switch from I'm on the club page and I'm me posting a comment, or nope, I am the club, the anonymous club posting this comment. We try to post, I'd say about 80% of our content is posted by the club, not by a particular human's name. Let's see. A lot of people like that. So that home section that we saw for me, well, there's a home section for the club. And here you can kind of see everything that's going on, right? And you can also see now it changed. And it says up in the top, instead of my name, it says Rotary Club of Framingham. So that's my clue, that right now I am looking at all this as if I am the club. Let's see. And so what are we getting over here? What's the news? Right? They talk about this news feed. So who do we? Why are we getting any news? Well, because as the club, I went out to the Rotary Club pages and I liked them. So now on our club page is now following several other clubs, including district. So when district posts and I come in as the club, I see that district has posted and I decide if I want to use that or, you know, go, oh, something I need, thanks. So that's kind of people that we grant money to, I immediately go and like their Facebook page. I want to keep track of what our grant recipients are doing and what they're involved in. Yep?
Can every club member on their own personal Facebook page, can they have like a button there that takes someone directly to your club page?
Kind of more like your club members can tell others about it. So they can make a posting that says, have you seen the Rotary Club's page? And they can, if they've liked the page, right? So if I'm just a club member and I go to the club's page and I like it, now it's in my news feed. And so when I now post on my page and say, hey, have you seen what the club is doing? If I type what the club at Rotary whatever is doing, it becomes a hyperlink to the club page. Yeah.
There's a way of kind of getting directly for someone else visiting your personal page.
Yes. And we do that a lot now. That's why we like to follow the organizations we're working with, because then when we post on our page, we can now say at that group, and it's a courtesy. So we, you know, had a fabulous event with this group. This group, we're following their page, and it means anybody who sees that post will go right to that group's Facebook page. So it's a really nice courtesy. Yes. Yes. So you want to follow the groups you want to be working with. Now, it just so happens I don't believe I'm actually following Rotary International. It's a little bit too big and hairy what's going on there. While I'm very interested in what district doing, I'm a little bit less interested in all the other. I've got events. So you have a big thing coming up, and you want to get people to come to it. On your club's page, it's a little hidden away, as you can see. There's a little pull down, and it's very discreet, and it says events. It sets up a little sub page on Facebook where you can explain your event, highlight it, and it becomes kind of all about that. And that's very handy to have from a PR purpose. There are a lot of news organizations online that are looking for content. Hungry beast, right? And they want something to do. And so when you post that and they're following, then they see that and they will post this event link and it gets out to more people. So let me, I have the instructions for setting up an event, but I'm going to jump to the end. All right, one of the powers of event, hold on. An event has a unique piece of functionality. It allows anybody who came to the event to say, ooh, let me send it to all of my Facebook friends. So let's say your Facebook friend, you know, your mom has 50 friends that are following her Facebook page. And she comes and sees this event. She can, from this page, send it with like one click to all 50 friends. So if every one of your members were following your page and came to the event, they could send it to everybody on Facebook who's following them. So it's a huge cascading thing that can happen. Only half our members are following on Facebook page. So there's a challenge, right? So that's why we like events, because it's a cascading way. How am I doing? 1 minute left? Okay, the Facebook cover. We all take pictures. Most pictures are square. Facebook's looking for a rectangle. You got this great picture. You try to stick it in here, and it gets cut off, up and down. It's not great. There is a handout to explain this. We give you the ideal resizing to get it in there. So don't go nuts thinking I can only do a panorama shot and get it in there. But we struggled with that for quite a while, getting an ideal one. And there's a little teeny tiny shadowy camera buried on the picture that you click to say, oh, I want to change that out. And when you change your cover, it's automatically a post to your page. Everybody following your page goes, what? What was that? So when we put up our event as a piece of art, that went to everybody following our page. We didn't have to say anything. Club administration. So there's a little place. First off, an administrator has to give rights. Whoever created the page is automatically an administrator. Then you need to start giving it to other people in your club. They have to be a Facebook person already. So we have one person wants to help us right now, and he didn't have a Facebook page. I'm like, dude, set up your Facebook page, and then we can connect you, all right? And there's a couple of levels of what they can do. And you can see we've got like four or five people, right? You want to think about who you're having help. They don't have to post constantly. Maybe they're only helping you with one thing. Maybe they're the person that just posts about speakers. That's fine. That's helpful. And it's something they can do as needed when the speakers are coming due. So you can chunk up the work on Facebook. What to post and when. Number four is probably the biggest point. After much experimentation and discussion, we came up with a methodology, sort of a cascading approach to what, how we handle content, right? Number one, events. That's the premier thing we want to do. People, we want to get people to our events. So that's the premier kind of posting. And you're going to see this as an example of what we try to say about it. Number two, this will be teasers for our event. We have a very big auction. Long before the auction actually happens, we're putting up these little teaser about the items, right? So ongoing, you know, the drip campaign concept around marketing. Well, okay, you posted your event, it's built, but you want to keep kind of posting about it. Number three is we celebrate club involvement, right? So there's two examples of what we posted. And we spent a long time trying to figure out, like, how do you make it short? How do you make it punchy? How do you make it relevant? And you notice all of these have pictures. Then we went to activities around our town is number four. Cross-posting other club stuff. Hey, if I don't have something going on at my club this week, but my neighbor club does, I'm happy to cross-post that for them. And district stuff. And then when we're really, things are slow, we might go snag an overarching Rotary message. Bono's recent thank you to Rotary for all it does, we just posted. Okay, so this basically says a website has your org information. Social media and Facebook is about generating excitement and involvement, not the same. You know, what we also found is posting something is better than nothing. So words, some words better than no words. Posting a photo with your words will get you more attention and more people looking at it. Posting a video will get you even more. Posting a video that involves anything about the kids in your town will skyrocket it. So that's kind of, you know, the progression. So we've actually begun working a lot more around videos because we want, and they're short, you know, 30 seconds, 1 minute, you know, because people want to look at that. So they're more willing to like your page if you're periodically posting something about that. So we think a lot more visually now in our club. Get some pictures. Get that up there. Our latest is Dick Mantelis just came back from Guyana where they did a project from building a play or repairing a playground in Guyana. Dick had 152 pictures. Crunched it down. I think it's like 2.5 minutes. That's very popular right now, right? So that's what I'd recommend you do, think kind of visually. So I'm sorry, I probably ran long.
Okay.
But and it was great questions people asked. I'd really highly recommend you take the chip sheets. And that you also take the presentation down from the web if you'd like. And I hope this was useful.